First of all, I'm from UPC, and on behalf of UPC, I will give you a brief presentation on Parkinson's syndrome. So Parkinson's syndrome is a painful condition in which there's a buildup of pressure in the muscles. This buildup in pressure, what this can result in is a decrease in blood flow. And with the decrease in blood flow, there will be the nutrients required will not be received by the muscles. And that could lead in damage to the nerve and muscle cells. So in basically our muscles, they are divided into compartments. Now these compartments, they're surrounded by a tough inelastic fascia. This fascia is inelastic, it does not expand easily, which is why when there is a pressure buildup because of compartment syndrome, when there's a pressure buildup, the fascia, it constricts all the muscles, and this pressure buildup eventually leads to a decrease in blood flow, thereby progressively shutting off the blood flow and the muscles are prevented from receiving the oxygen and nutrients that they need. This is a summary of what's just been said. When there's a rise in the pressure in the compartment, that could result in venule collapse, which further results in a reduced anterior venous pressure gradient, resulting in an increased arterial hydrostatic pressure, and finally reduced tissue perfusion, by which the muscles do not receive the adequate nutrition and oxygen. This is the cross-section of the compartments. When there's a buildup of pressure in these compartments, eventually what will happen is, again, the blood flow will progressively be shut off. The muscles will not receive, the muscle cells and the nerve cells, they will not receive the oxygen and nutrients that they will need. And if it's not treated properly, then this can result in permanent damage to these cells. Now, there are two types of compartment syndrome. We have acute compartment syndrome and we have chronic compartment syndrome. Acute compartment syndrome, it's a medical emergency, and it's usually caused by a severe injury, and most of the time it happens in the anterior compartment of the leg. And if not treated properly, it can lead to permanent muscle damage. Then we have another type. The second type is chronic compartment syndrome, and it's also known as exertional compartment syndrome. It's not a medical emergency, and we usually observe this in athletes. And if they forego the physical activity that causes it, then usually that's how it's treated. Now, these are the different forms of compartment syndrome. We have trauma, which can include fracture, crush syndrome, soft tissue injury, bleeding, reperfusion injury, intensive muscle use, burns, snake bite, venous obstruction, injection injuries. The symptoms that we see in patients, that they experience pain which is more than the injury itself. They have a tingling or burning sensation in their skin. Their muscles may feel tight or full, and they may experience numbness. Okay, when they go for physical examination, the doctors usually check for pain. These are the six P's. We check for pain, pressure, paresthesia or numbness, pallor, a faint color, pulselessness, a faint pulse. And treatment for acute compartment syndrome, you have to immediately relieve the source of pressure, and that's usually by a fasciotomy, in which there's a small cut and they relieve the pressure. Chronic compartment syndrome, you can avoid it by avoiding the physical activities that cause it, physical therapy, and also anti-inflammatory.
Hospital. Hello, Dr. Sugar. No, why is it? Oh, no, no. scenario, you have acute patient, acute compartment syndrome. The treatment only was fissure tummy. We hope Laura, we did a tummy.